Hello everyone, welcome back to another episode. And in this video tutorial, I will talk about the Jacobian matrix, which is actually a key concept in numerical methods for power system analysis. So it is actually used to describe the relationship between the changes, the system bus voltages, and the magnitude and the corresponding changes in the real and reactive power injections. So in this load flow analysis code, I will explore the purpose of J1, J2, J3, J4, which is actually are used to calculate the correction factor X, which contains the changes in the voltage angles and magnitudes required to bring the system into a balance state. So these changes are applied iteratively until the system converges to a solution where the mismatch are minimized. So sometime when we run this Jacobian matrix, which is normally used in the Newton-Raphson load flow analysis, so sometime the system does not converge. So it can be possible because here, right over here, we are doing the injection into this program. So sometime the injection through the optimization algorithm, which we are going to do, is not giving us the correct results. So that's possible. So in this code, I will just focus on the Jacobian matrix. And if you understand the purpose of Jacobian matrix, you can barely understand the whole purpose of Newton-Raphson load flow method. So the Jacobian matrix plays a crucial role in the Newton-Raphson load flow analysis, as it helps to linearize the power flow equations and speed up the convergence of iterative process. So it's basically a fundamental tool for understanding how voltage variations affect power flow in the system, and it's an integral part of the power system analysis and control. So let's begin with the Jacobian matrix. Right over here, you can see that it's basically have four parts. So let's begin with the J1. So as the J1, which is actually the derivative of power flow injections with the angles. So which means that the purpose of J1 is to represent how changes in the voltage angles at each bus except the reference bus affect the real power injections at all bus. So means by changing the angles, J1 will monitor the outcomes, the injections at real power injections at all buses. So what will be the effect of angles? So here we start with the zeros. Number n bus is representing the total number of buses. And it's a start with the -1, the total number of buses right over here. So this is the I and this is the N. So normally this is the N equals to M, which is actually representing the diagonal elements. And this is the else condition, which is actually representing the off diagonal elements. So actually the code initializes with the matrix J1 with the size of n bus -1, and it actually calculates the partial derivative right over here. The partial derivative of real power injections with respect to the voltage angles. And this is done using the power flow equations. So it have different kind of equation for the off diagonal elements. And let's next jump to the J2, and right over here in the J2, J2 is actually used to show how changes in the voltage magnitude at PV and PQ buses affect the real power injections at PQ buses. So it initializes a matrix J2 with the size minus 1 from the total number of buses, and right over here the NPQ, which is actually is the number of the PQ buses. So the code iterates over each bus. Iterative process starts from here, from this stage. So the code iterative over each bus except the reference bus and each PQ bus to compute the partial derivative of real power injection with respect to the voltage magnitude of the PQ bus. So right over here, this is the formulation for the diagonal elements, and this is for the off diagonal elements. And now the third part, which is actually the J3, which is designed to indicate how changes in the voltage angles at each bus impact the reactive power injections at PQ buses. So it initializes matrix J3 with the size NPQ, which represent the total number of PQ buses. The code iterates over each PQ bus, and each bus have to calculate the partial derivative of reactive power injections with respect to the voltage angles of the PQ buses. And finally, there is the J4, and in the J4, J4 shows how change in the voltage magnitudes at PV and PQ buses affect the real power injections at PQ buses. So that's how the J1, J2, and J3, J4 works. So Jacobian matrices are essential for Newton-Raphson load flow analysis, where they help linearize the power flow equations, enabling the system to iteratively converge to a balanced state more efficiently. They provide valuable insights into how voltage variations influence power injections in the power system. So that's how it works. Please like the video and subscribe to the channel.